Hey guys, it's Peter, and I'm back. Of course I'm back. I'm not going anywhere. Beast! I'm YouTube famous now. Available in 2000 BC. The album that I give to you. Dad! AF. Whatever you want. It's a little too early for me to be crooning. I'm a crooner, see? Anyway, okay, let's get right into this video. Now, if you were missing Dramageddon 2.0 Spring Break, ding-a-ling-a-ling, shamalang-dang-ding-dong. I have no voice today. Ding! That's because I did a really long vlog last night. Not a really long vlog, but I told this whole serial killer story on there. So, if you don't know, what you don't know is a lot. I have a vlog channel. People are listening to it like a podcast. Go check it out. I upload every day, like an hour. I have 5 channels. I upload on all 5 of them every day. Why wouldn't you watch them? Ding! House of Drama, Drama Phone. This is Peter speaking. Oh, hi, Jane. How are you? No, I'm just sitting up here. Have a gimlet, Jane. A gimlet. Oh, I know I shouldn't be drinking them on a Sunday. It's God's day. But I am. Anyway. Well, I was missing my favorite show on the Hulu. The Hulu, Jane. The Hulu. Uh-huh. My favorite show. It's called Dramageddon. Uh-huh. Well, the first part was last summer. Uh-huh. It was starring Laura Lee and Manny Mua. I love that Manny Mua so much. Uh-huh. Yeah. Canceled. I don't know if his show got canceled. Laura Lee, now her show definitely got canceled. Uh-huh. Well, then they came out with part 2. Yeah. And that was starring James Charles. And that Jeffree Star. Oh, I love that Jeffree Star. Uh-huh. Oh, I know all the drama channels. They love him too. I know. Uh-huh. And then that Tati Westbrook. Uh-huh. Well, she's more of a mature actress. Uh-huh. Best supporting actress, we like to call her. Well, now I'm waiting for Dramageddon Part 3, Jane. It's coming out on Hulu very soon. Uh-huh. Yeah, this one, I think, might be starring Shane Dawson. We'll have to see, Jane. I don't know, but I'm very excited. In the interim, I think there's going to be a preview today. Uh-huh. It's a Sunday matinee movie on the Hulu. You have to go check it out. Okay, bye, Jane. So anyway, people ask me, they're like, do you script those? Do you think I script those? Do you think I have any idea what I'm saying when I pick up that phone? No, I'm talking to Jane. Anyway, okay, so a little bit of a rundown of Dramageddon there. We already know we caught up, right? But everybody's like, oh, is it done? Is it done? Is it done? It is not done, okay? It is like a pressure cooker inside the beauty influencer community right now. We have so many unanswered questions, and I'm not going to go into that because I've said it in every video. But we have so many unanswered questions, and you have to realize that these people that we're talking about, I know that to a lot of you stans out there, they seem very humble and sweet and whatever, but no, okay? All these people are extremely arrogant, they're extremely successful, and they have people literally all around them all the time telling, oh my God, you're the greatest thing in the whole entire world, I love you, love you, love you, and all this kind of stuff. Now, you start to believe that, right? Until you get the hairy lipsticks. Now listen, okay? If you're a beauty influencer out there and you're trying to sell the world a hairy lipstick, go check out my video from yesterday, okay? Nobody wants the hairy lipstick, Jaclyn Hill, I'm just saying, okay? So anyway, but, you know, we're talking about people that are very successful and very arrogant, and some of them at a very, very young age, right? And so this need to rectify situations to be right, okay, to always say, hey, listen, I'm right, is going to come out more than some others. Because for some of these people that have been around for a while, that are mature, that are in their 30s and above, we're probably not going to see so much of that behavior, possibly, unless they're developmentally not mature, which we can see by a lot of their behaviors. But younger people, like James Charles, are going to pop off eventually because they want people to know, I was right, I proved that I was right, and they're going to keep on saying it until people believe it, or they force other people to come out and say other things. And I think that is what's going to happen, and that is going to be Dramageddon Part 3. I think James Charles is going to continue to push and push and push, and he's going to continue to poke the bear of all these people. And I don't think it'll be Tati that comes out. I think indirectly, I think Jeffree Star in some way will, I don't know. I don't know how it's going to happen, but I'm telling you, before the end of the summer, those two are going to be at it again. Because James Charles, he just can't let this whole thing die. And I'm like, you know, to some degree, you need to think about this, James, right? Like, You lost more subscribers on your channel than any other YouTuber in the history of YouTube, right? You literally gained almost all of them back, and you are doing okay. People are leaving you alone, and yet you're continuing to put out statements. So I'm continuing to be surprised. I am continuing to be surprised. I'm very surprised by all of it. I'm so surprised that it needs a dueling fan. Okay, so anyway, if you don't know what you don't know, it's a lot. Yesterday, Joey Graceffa put this tweet up right here. He said, to celebrate my YouTube anniversary, here's a look back at my scandals over the past 12 years. And he put one video thing up, and it says, I towed Joey Graceffa's car. Basically insinuating that, like, he has had no scandals in the last 12 years. Which, in thinking back, other than who he cast for Escape the Night, I really don't think he has had a lot of scandals, you know? I'm just saying. I mean, he hasn't had a whole lot of scandals. You know, back in the day, everybody watched Joey Graceffa, but now, like, when I talk to people and I'll say, like, oh, who do you watch for as YouTubers? And I'll be like, do you watch this person? Do you watch that person? And they're like, no. And I'm like, do you watch Joey Graceffa? And they're like, not really anymore, I don't, you know? So anyway, but congratulations, Joey, on 12 years on YouTube. So then, right underneath it, this was so funny. Here, I'm going to put it up for you, how it showed up on the Twitter, okay? Here you go. Here were the first two famous responders, responders, like EMT responders, Jeffree Star put, can't relate, and right underneath it, James Charles put, must be nice, okay? Well, what's interesting about James Charles saying must be nice, right, is that he is the one, and so is Jeffree Star, who says can't relate, that are constantly the ones driving this drama. If you don't want drama around you, just don't have it, you know? Like, you have a choice how much of that you put out there. You know, for example, because I'm going to be referencing this in just a second, James Charles with the sugar bear hair thing. He didn't have to do that. He could have hired his own security. We already, like, that whole story. And, you know, it makes me wonder, and I want to talk about this at the end of this video, had he never done the sugar bear hair ad, would we even know any of this? Would any of this come out, right? So, for him to say, must be nice, you know, it's like, well, you're kind of the one that starts most of the drama you get yourself involved in, James. I mean, in all honesty, take some ownership over your mess, right? And then Jeffree Star saying, can't relate. I mean, Jeffree Star literally inserts himself into every piece of drama that is out there, period, in the story. So for him to say, can't relate, it's like, well, you put yourself right in the middle of this whole mess. And then James Charles, hold on a second, he tweeted out after that, up here, he said, I can't wait to be able to genuinely say I am happy again. And I have to say, when I read that tweet, it made me kind of sad, honestly, you know? And it made me sad for two reasons. When I first read it, I was kind of like, you know, this kid for his age has maybe, like, been through a lot, I think, social media-wise. I feel bad for him. It's a lot. That was the first thing. The second thing, that it made me sad for was how inflated he is at this point, that he truly doesn't see what a life he was offered. You know, that there's not a lot of gratitude there, right? When you're saying, I can't wait till the day that I'm genuinely happy again. When the majority of your tweets and Instagram stories for, like, the last month, even going through all this kind of stuff, is like living my best life, having the best time in my life, blah, 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 whatever. And really the only thing that he says is that, you know, most of the time is that he doesn't like being single. Okay, well, the thing is with that, you're rather young, okay? You own your own home. You have a very successful businesses at this point. You have a mass following. You have a lot of friends around you that really care about you. The ones that don't, okay? But instead of being grateful for what you have, you look at what you don't have. And that makes me sad. And I think that's a horrible lesson to be sending out to the younger generation. I do, you know? I think all of us on a daily basis could work with a little bit more gratitude and be like, hey, I feel pretty blessed for what I have, you know? I don't know. If he was sitting in front of me, I'd say, James, maybe you need to check what your level of happiness is defined by, you know? What do you need? You have a Tesla, you have a car, you have all this. Did you realize one day when you woke up that this dream that you were chasing, that you are giving to the world and showing that this is the American dream, that, or the international world dream, whatever, to, you know, make it, be famous, have all the cars, have all the trips, travel over here, is actually very, very lonely. And what in the end really matters the most is people and your relationships with them and moments that you spend with them. Because if that's the case, what's really, really sad about this is that the whole sugar bear hair thing really comes down to the definition of loyalty within a friendship, right? Because if he were really loyal to Toddy, No matter if he needed the security, no matter if he didn't, he would never have done it, okay? If he had any inkling that his friendship with her would have been totally just, could have fallen apart over this, right? Which he would have had to have thought at some point that she really holds dear, this whole Halo thing. So it's not about how many times has he mentioned it, how many times didn't he mention it, on and on and on. What did she do for him? What did she not do for him? And it's like, you know, I talk about this a lot, but my good Judy, my best friend, she owns a dog kennel, right? I'm not really sure what it would take for somebody else to sponsor me for their dog kennel, their local dog kennel. So it would have to be like a complete, you know, competitor that I would even consider that. I just wouldn't. And it's not number one because of the money. And it's not number two because I just think that my friend's kennel is the best. It's because I would never do that to her, number one. Number two, there's no amount of money that I would put on my loyalty towards her or my friendship. So I don't understand that. Like, it makes absolutely no sense to me whatsoever, right? So this is really not about all of this scandal. This is really about his loyalty as a friend. And I think that what's really sad about this is James is somebody that's going to be very misguided in having to, you know, realize that his definition of happiness is not what he thought it was. It's not Coachella weekends and 50 friends at a really cool house in Palm Springs. It's not traveling around the world in, you know, jets. And it's not having the world's greatest Tesla or your house at 19 and all this kind of stuff. It's not, you know, walking in fashion shows. It's simplicity. It's moments that you spend with people. And when you trade those off for money, okay, and you trade those off for fame, in the end, your life is rather empty. And I think that he's going to have to learn that the hard way, which is really, really sad to me, you know? So, and he doesn't have to. He doesn't have to. He needs to pull it in a little bit. But I also think that those are things that we learn from our family, we learn from our friends. You know, I feel very blessed to be surrounded by people that live very much that way. And, you know, it's like, I have a lot of people in my life that financially are very, very successful. But they don't forget, you know, those moments. They don't forget the importance of people, that at the end of our lives, when we look back, it's not on how many Birkins you carried. It's not on, and I know this is getting a little preachy and I don't really care because it's how I feel in my heart of hearts. At the end of your life, you know, when you look back, it's probably not how many Birkins you carried or how many trips you took or whatever. The end of your life is probably about who did you take those trips with, you know? Who did you, like, spend nights with at night? You know, who did you talk to on the phone? Those moments that you'll never forget, laughter that you had in a car where you almost couldn't stop laughing with a good friend. If you're not having moments like that, what's all of the rest of it for, you know? So then last night, he put up, God knows, well, first of all, he put up this picture, and here, I'm going to put up the very bottom of it. He's standing, like, in his bathroom, and he's showing his spray tan, okay? And he said on there, excuse my dusty ass mirror, but thank you. And then he added, Isabella, Lisa, for keeping me tan. So apparently she, like, spray tanned him or something. What I thought was really funny was that in the bottom corner of the left-hand corner of his sink, do you see he has that Got To Be hairspray bottle? Which I think is really interesting that he uses Got To Be hairspray. With all of his really supporting glam and luxury products and things like that, that the hairspray that he uses is just, and hey, I love, thank you for it, James, okay? Because the message that you're sending out there to the younger generation is you don't have to spend $25 on a bottle of hairspray, okay? Listen, we know that, okay? Back in the day, if you're from my era and you had the big hair, the perm and the state fair hair claw, you know what I'm talking about? All my girlfriends had that back in the day. You just hold your hair up and then you'd spray it with the Aquanet. Everybody knows the Aquanet was $1.99. It was the hairspray back in the day. So anyway, but that kind of surprised me that he used that. But then he put up this a tweet. And it was, of course, another one of these typewritten tweet things, or tweet. Woo! Please hold, I need some water. This is my new, I'm trying to get into all of the, like, not buying plastic bottles or, you know, Starbucks. I have all my, this is from Lakai, so. You're also saving the oceans. And why wouldn't we want to save the oceans? Because the oceans are where the sharks are. And the sharks are my biggest fear, which is why I watch Jaws all summer long. Okay, so then James put up this on his Instagram. And let me read it to you, okay? Because it's very long. He must have thought late last night, well, I've accomplished all my goals. Now I want to be an author. Okay, so here it is. There have been a lot of comments on my page, my friends' pages, and brand pages that I am associated with about recent events on social media. Recent events, I think he's referring to Dramageddon and all the allegations against him. I think that's what he's referring to. I am going to have to deal with these lies, accusations, and being called horrible names for the rest of my life. And it effing sucks. But I have already proven the accusations to be 100% false. Well, you kinda did. I mean, some of the accusations, there's a lot of accusations out there you never addressed at all. People are still wondering what's going on. There's a lot of things you said that don't make any sense whatsoever. You know, like one of the things that he said in there was that the Dolan twins were one of the first people that reached out to them, and maybe that they distanced themselves because of all the stuff. Well, if James has truly, you know, proven that that's not who he is, the Dolan twins still aren't following him, and I do believe that they are following Jeffree Star. So, you know, it's like, well, you're following Jeffree Star, but you're not following. So this is saying that you aren't saying that I want to be completely away from all of this. You don't mind if you're part of the drama, but you're part of Jeffree Star, but you're not part of James Charles. So it still makes you wonder what the background story is all of that. So anyway, I don't know. But then he goes in here and he's, so, I mean, not everything has been, you know, like, we don't know all the answers. Let's just be for real. We don't. Because one day, it was just dot, 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 and then it was all cleaned up, and they thought we're all going to buy into this. But there's a lot of things we don't know. He said, I am going to have to deal with these lies, accusations, and being called horrible names for the rest of my life. And it effing sucks. But I've already proven the accusations to be 100% false. And at this 100% false, I think is a really strong statement to make. It's almost kind of like Jacqueline Cosmetics coming out and saying the 0.01. Okay? Like, let's just be for real. And at this point, there is not much more I can do. I have to be patient, show my true character, but also understand that there will always be people who do not want to believe the full story because to many, drama is more entertaining than the truth. Drama that you created, drama about you, drama about your life. I mean, this is the thing that I think he doesn't understand. This is why people are continuing to say that James is arrogant, okay? This is not just about Toddy. This is about 50 different things, and I don't believe that 100% of them have been addressed. I don't think 50% of them have been addressed, and if it were me and he had talked to me, I would have said, this is how I would have handled it, and I would have, you know, I mean, there was a way to handle this, but no, it hasn't been addressed, and to come out with a statement like this, I think just further shows you're backing people's belief about your character, that this is what it is. You're just gonna, you know? So anyway, believe the full story because to many, drama is more entertaining than the truth. It's sad, but this is the internet culture we created, and I don't want these people following me anyway. Be very careful. Be very, very careful when you tell people, I don't care if you follow me or not. I just don't think that's ever a smart move. From a PR move, don't ever put that thought in people's head to not follow you, okay? Because they just did unfollow you. Many, many, many people unfollowed you. And just because you got them back doesn't mean that you can't lose them again. And what it says to me is that you're not real grateful for the followers that you have. We already know if you had 16 million followers, not all of them were in love with you. So are you telling 2 million of them to unfollow you? Okay, what you're saying is 2 million followers is nothing to me. It's sad that this is the internet culture we created, and I don't want these people following me anyway. I know what he's saying, basically, is if you don't like me, don't follow me. I get that, right? But that's grandiose, and that's arrogant, okay? And it's bad business. I know that a lot of you guys want to defend me, and I appreciate that, but I ask that if you do, do it politely, please. The best way to combat rumors and lies is with kindness, maturity, and facts. Well, how would anybody defending you against lies, how would they know? They don't live your life. They're not with you. So how could they possibly? So what you're talking about is stands that are sticking up for you that don't know the truth. Because you really have only addressed what you chose to address, okay? And I don't hate James Charles. I want to make that very, very clear. And he knows that. Don't be mean, don't call names, and don't stoop to their level. It's unnecessary, and if we've learned anything from the past few weeks, it's that negativity and fighting gets us nowhere. Please be kind or don't say anything at all. Negativity will be blocked. Love you all. Well, you know what's interesting to me about this is that if James had called me up and said, well, what do you think I should do to handle this situation? Do you think I should put out this statement, which to me, okay, I have to just say, came out of the complete blue. Like, it didn't make any sense to me at all why he's putting the statement out. I'm sure he's getting negativity on his social media from time to time, but I looked under his Twitter yesterday and he's not getting a whole lot. And unless he's got hiring groups of people to, like, you know, manage his Instagram, I'm not seeing that he's getting complete hate over there. He ain't put a video out, okay, since he apparently, you know, I don't know why he's not putting videos out. He should. And, you know, what you love to do is make videos and do makeup looks. And that's what makes you genuinely happy. Do what makes you genuinely happy. Put out another video. If you're afraid of what people's response is going to be, so be it. You got to come back at some point, you know? And the thing is that he's going to have to just at some point, James, if you're watching this, at some point, just shut up, zip it, okay? You don't need to continue to put these statements out there. To me, what this says is I'm trying to stir it up again. I'm trying to recreate the drama around me, because when there's drama going on around me and people are talking and people are speculating, because listen, nobody was talking about you. Not that I'm aware of. We were talking about Jaclyn Cosmetics. And in the middle of Jaclyn Cosmetics, the drama channels, okay, you put this statement out there. Now we're all like, what's going on? So to me, this is like, you know, somebody saying, hey, look at me, look at me, look at me. I don't know. Do you like drama or do you not like drama? I guess that's what we'll find out going forward. And yeah, that is part of your character and that is part of that, you know? But I also think that, you know, we learn as we grow. And I really, really hope that James learns from this experience. I hope that he is a better friend to people, but I also hope that he chooses better friends in the future, you know? And I think that, you know, there are red flags with all of that. And, you know, like all of us, I hope that he wakes up on a daily basis and asks himself, how can I be the best version of myself today? I love you guys, and I will see you in my next video. And you know it's going to be a Jaclyn Hill video, so just wait. Bye.